You know, one of the disappointments through my career was being able to not reach people that needed help because they didn't seem to be able to implement the recommendations. And those that, as you know, thousands of people have and made tremendous recoveries, but I knew that if I could get people away for 2 to 3 months, almost like a drug rehab center, then I can get their taste buds changed, get them to be able to have a better, lose that illicit love affair they have with dangerous foods that fade with time. Like, you're off cigarettes, you're off cocaine, you stay away from cigarettes and cocaine for 3 months, you're not going to crave it as much. And we see that. And then people who think they can't do this, they even come in and don't even want to do it. They're forced to be here. The parents force them to be here. They think they're going to... They're here at time, and they may... Their taste buds change. They learn to eventually love eating this way. They see the miraculous effects it has on their body. And their emotional outlook on life changes. Even their personalities make a change. And they leave here with the ability to continue to make progress and to live healthfully the rest of their life. It's been my dream to have a place like this because I know there was so many people I couldn't reach, and now I can reach these people and help them. And, you know, I've always had this idea that, you know, you got to be satisfied and to help the people you can help and not feel so bad about the people you can't reach and can't help. That, and we all get pleasure from helping other people. And most people... a lot of people, you know, couldn't even afford to come here or couldn't have the time commitment to stay here. And they've got to make their home environment like a retreat where they get rid of all the temptation, where they learn how to make the food taste great, where they know they have to get enforcement from their family and friends to keep on track. They can't dabble in dangerous foods that they're hooked onto.
Right.
Because when you have one foot in both worlds, you never want to give up the other world. It keeps you wanting to attract those foods all the time.
So this balanced diet is an excuse for people to deviate from an ideal whole foods diet.
Right. The idea that people go back and forth and don't go into it 100% is almost always the cause of their difficulties. Once they jump in with both feet and make no further decisions, no stressful deciding whether they're going to eat healthfully or not, they know every meal is going to be super duper healthy and they're going to chew it really well, and they're going to get the most out of it. Then it takes the stress off their life, and their personalities start to change, and they learn to really appreciate the beauty and the magic of natural foods, what it can do for their body, and they see it finally happen. So, you know, they say the money's in the last 5%. You know what I mean by that? Hmm. Well, when I was a competitive figure skating coach,
okay,
and I had people training for the Olympics, and, you know, you'd say, well, you're doing fantastic. You're an unbelievable star, but you're not going to make, you know, a big salary or get to the Olympics or anything like that because you're not willing to put in that last 5%.
Oh.
It's, you can put in 95% and be good, but you're not going to be great unless you put in 100%. You got to just do these, and some people can't, and it's that extra.
The devil's in the detail.
The devil's in the detail, and we see the same thing here. When people do everything right, all the little things that bothered them, they couldn't think this wasn't working for them, they couldn't get better, then the magic happens, and they finally get rid of their reflux, their bloating, their arthritis, their carpal tunnel. Things start to get better. I still have high blood pressure, even though I've been eating this way. You know, but you're not really eating this way 100%. But so then and then people find it easier to stick with it than had they done it 95%. Of course, you and I, let's say, who are not food addicts, we don't have to do it 100% if we didn't want to. I want to. But if I didn't want to, going off the diet and having one thing that wasn't perfect wouldn't trigger me into a binge, and it wouldn't make me want to eat those things again for the next month. But for a lot of people who are food addicts, who we see here, they can't dabble, and they especially for the first few months. So I knew that so many people go to health retreats, stay away for a week or two, and they get some benefit, but they go home, they gain the weight back.
Right.
And what benefit was there if they only got a temporary benefit? None. Nothing. None. There's only a success if whatever benefit you got, that you continue to get move in that direction till you got all the way there and you never had any recidivism that made you regain weight. In other words, and that's what we accomplish here. We accomplish that people prefer to eat this way. They're able to leave and stick with it and enjoy it. And our chefs are phenomenal. And they show them how they make healthy food taste good. Their taste buds change. So I'm really you know, enthusiastic and passionate about the opportunity I have for be able to reach people that I couldn't reach before.